across Australia.
Swifts spoil their party. Caitlin Thwaites for the opener. Chance for a 4-goal lead for the Swifts. And they have set the challenge down to the Queensland Firebirds. The New South Wales Swifts came into this final as the underdog and they take a 4-goal lead into the final change. The pressure is all on the Swifts. Surely they can't lose it from here. The Firebirds are yet to hit the front. Everyone's up on their feet. And Hathley's hurt.
Oh, God, she's grabbed at her ribs.
Well, as it stands now, the New South Wales Swifts have got one hand on the ANZ Championship trophy. Tippett doesn't want to take the shot.
She's going to have to.
They're eating into it. Gretel Tippett hit the front for the very first time with 14 seconds left on the clock. And Laura Guides, the superstar of Australian netball. The Queensland Firebirds are going to hold on and they're playing game. Can you believe it? Pure euphoria at the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. It's highway robbery. They've stolen it. They've pitched it in the dying seconds. It was the most exhilarating grand final the sport has seen, and 406 days later, we meet again. The ANZ Championship will come to a close today by hosting a grand final rematch. The Firebirds can farewell the competition in style by becoming the first team to go back-to-back. The New South Wales Swifts are here to spoil the party. They won the first ever ANZ Championship in 2008. They can bookend the competition with another title here today. We've waited all season and we are finally here. It's the Queensland Firebirds and the New South Wales Swifts in the 2016 ANZ Championship Grand Final. Hello and welcome to Brisbane Entertainment Centre. It's Kelly Underwood alongside a two-time ANZ Championship winner, Catherine Cox. And Kath, I mean, this place is buzzing at the moment. Happy Grand Final Day. Oh,
thank you, Kelly. It's a lot like Christmas Day, isn't it? The best day of the year.
It certainly is. And these tickets, they sold out in a matter of 30 minutes, 10,000, and everyone wants a piece of the rematch.
And why would you not? We remember vividly what happened last year. It was close. It was an awesome game. We all want to see it happen again.
Well, it's one of the great rivalries in Australian sport at the moment. Since the Epic Grand Final last year, they have played three times. This was the first time, round five on this court, and it was the Gretel Tippett, Romelda Aitken show. The Swifts seemed a little bit wound up. They were a little bit too emotional for that. They lost by 10. Then in front of a record crowd of 13,300, it was in Sydney. The Swifts made a match-winning move. Coach Rob Wright brought Steph Wood on at halftime, and a star was born. They got there in the end by 4 goals, and they ended that 21-game winning streak of the Firebirds. And then it was here a fortnight ago in the Australian Conference Final. The Firebirds were simply unrelenting. There's no chink in the armour in the 60 minutes of netball they put out in the Aussie Conference Final, and they won by 11. So the Swifts yet to beat them in Brisbane from 11 attempts, Cap.
Massive, massive ask for the Swiss. They will know that. They'll have that in the back of their head. But what they've got to do, completely forget about it. Get out here, do the job. They are more than capable of winning here this afternoon.
Well, Rob Wright for the Swifts. The Mind Games began yesterday. He labelled the Firebirds starting seven the Super Seven. Take us through this Super
Seven. Well, here they are. No surprises. This Super Seven is staying much the same. Laura Guides, Claire McMinimum teaming up in the defensive circle. The midcourt fire, the Firebirds this afternoon. Nevins, Revillian, Gabby Simpson. On song, accurate, consistent. And here they are. The somewhat unconventional, but very exciting to watch. Gretel Tippett and Romelda Aitken in the shooting circle for the Firebirds. On the bench this afternoon, Beryl Friday, Clamisha, Cassidy, Lemke and Humica.
You've been able to identify some tactics throughout those three clashes this year, and you believe the Firebirds had the wood over them in the midcourt. They slow them down and they push them wide. Talk us through it.
Yeah, absolutely, Kel. The aim is to make sure that they are pushed wide. So watch the initial work Simpson and Revillian do. Put the early pressure on to slow them up. Now they make sure they push them out into the pockets. The idea being that the feed is a lot harder to get into the circle from the pockets of the circle. What it also does is bring Laura Geitz into the game. If that ball is swung or lifted, she can have a crack at it.
Laura Geitz, of course, she's the golden girl up here. She has the opportunity to enhance her longevity in the game, in a sense, this afternoon, because she is a World Cup winner, the Australian captain, of course, won a Com Games gold medal. She's a two-time winner in the ANZ Champs, a chance to make that three. And we caught up with her a short time ago. Our courtside reporter, Sarah Allen.
Laura, you have the chance to create history today. What is the last thing you'll say to the team before they run out?
Oh, look, I think just to embrace the occasion. You know, I think the 11,000 people in here screaming will create enough energy and excitement for us. I think the challenge for us is to stay calm and composed and play at our pace and have control over the match. So a message from me will be to remain calm in really stressful and exciting situations that you would guess that the grand final will produce, but just to enjoy it and embrace the occasion. Good luck today. Thanks, Ashley.
So we know that Laura Geitz gets Caitlin Thwaites, and Caitlin Thwaites cannot beat her over four quarters. Geitz has proved that before. So what does the coach do? Does he consider using Thwaites maybe as an impact player and start Steph Wood because it worked in Sydney?
Look, I am in two minds about this one. Caitlin Thwaites does generally play a good first quarter. I would start her and see how she went. What I wouldn't do is wait too long to make the change if it needed to happen.
Okay,
as we can see here in the Swiss lineup in the defensive end, Shani Layton, Maddie Turner, much the same. For the season so far, it's worked for them. The big change here we'll see in the midcourt. Abby McCulloch will take up the wing defence position. Paige Hadley missing out on that middle position there and sitting on the bench. Laura Langman, Kim Green. Great to see Kim Green back out on court. Caitlin Thwaites, Susan Pettit. You know what you're going to get from these two. They are reliable, as we spoke about. Don't know how long of the game Thwaites will play. Rob Wright does have the great Stephanie Wood on the bench, as we spoke about, being brought into the game. He might do that again. Moore, Hadley, Bryce and Somerville.
Well, we've spoken about the big matchup under one post, but what about under the under post? It's the career best form, Romelda Aitken, the towering Jamaican, against the Swifts enforcer, Shani Layton. Take us through this enthralling matchup.
You have got to love Romelda Aitken. So young, and as you say, playing some of the best netball of her life. Nearly 5,000 goals to her name. She gets the ball, she puts it through, averaging 47 goals a game. Consistent and composed. She hasn't necessarily been that in past years, but she has got it in check right now. Shani Layton, you know she's going to go out and have a crack at absolutely anything that comes anywhere near her. Leading the league in deflections and intercepts, 33 more intercepts than the next best. That just goes to show that she's next level. She's loud, she's vocal, she's going to inspire her team. I would put her down as the best goalkeeper in the current game.
Ooh, well, this final certainly does feature the two best defenders in the world. We've heard from Laura Geitz. Let's hear now from Shani Layton. She's with another defender, Bianca Chatfield.
Shani, it's D-Day today. Have you got your game face ready?
Yeah, I do, B.
You've got to give me more than that. How are you feeling before the big game?
Mate, this is just my favourite day of the year. You know, you work so hard to get to days like this, but, you know, at the end of the day, we've still got to be able to put it out there. So the girls are pretty excited. It's always tough coming up here to Brisbane. We know it's going to be a massive fight, but we're ready for it.
Good luck for the game.
Thanks, mate.
So Shani Layton, she gives away 8 centimetres to Romelda Aitken, and her coach has stated yesterday she is trying to keep the Jamaican to under 45 goals here this afternoon. And of course, Layton, the chance to become a triple premiership player as well, having won 2 titles with the Adelaide Thunderbirds. So the two teams going through their final preparations. Let's hear from the last word from our two sideline commentators this afternoon. Sarah.
Kel, the two teams are playing for this beauty today, and they've had vastly different lead-ins to this match. The Firebirds have played just 2 games in the last 3 weeks, both in Brisbane, and have had the same starting seven the whole way through, so they are as settled as ever.
And the Swifts, on the other hand, Rob Wright's been changing the starting seven. They've had 2 away games in their last 3 games in Brisbane and New Zealand, but they have experience, they're used to being the underdog, and in a grand final, anything can happen.
That's right, B. When the adrenaline is pumping, it doesn't matter how many kilometres you've travelled to get here, Kel.
So can Laura Geitz guide her team to back-to-back wins, or can the Swifts secure a grand final revenge? It is the season decider, and we will have the opening centre pass right after this. Let's go!
I'm 27. I'm a criminal cartels investigator. I'm going to be underestimated. I don't think I'm going to come across as an overly strategic person. No one's going to look at me and think, okay, this girl's pretty sharp. They're not going to see me coming until it's too late. If I need to flirt, then I'll flirt. If someone's into me, then I definitely want to exploit that.
This is our country. Our growing population. This is our leader. These are our colours. And our traditional dance. We speak our own language. These are our warriors. This is our army. And together, we are the Netball Nation.
Chances are, VIPs in your neighbourhood.
Cleaning your home or office is what we do best. Plus, VIP franchisees are fully insured and police checked. Give us a go. We're happy to help.
Why wait to be happy?
We all love a catch-up with friends, but not when the coffee hangs around afterwards. Chew Extra. For that just brushed clean feeling.
Welcome back to the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. A crowd of 10,000 fans, mainly in purple, packed into this venue. It is buzzing already. Last year it was pandemonium at the final whistle. I wonder how they will cope today. So the Queensland Firebirds haven't lost a final in Brisbane. The New South Wales Swifts have never won in Brisbane. Have Cox.
As we spoke about in the opener, Kel, it's a tough one, isn't it? The Swifts just need to put that out of their heads. They need to get on with this. It is a grand final. It is a completely different day. They'll have their game plan in mind. They'll have to just go out and execute it one ball at a time, not think too much about the bigger picture.
So only two players out there don't have international experience. Caitlin Nevins for the Firebirds and Maddie Turner in her rookie year. This time last year, she watched the grand final on her couch in Adelaide, and here she is playing the crucial task against Gretel Tippett. Jenkins searching for title number four. Rob Wright for his first. It's the rematch. It's the last hurrah. The 2016 ANZ Championship grand final is underway, and it's Firebirds in attack and a little fumble, and it's stolen by Green.
Well, what a start. This is exactly what the Swifts would have wanted. What they need to do now is score from it. It's something they've spoken about a lot this season. Getting those turnovers and making sure they get them down to a goal. No time is more important than in a grand final.
And Twaits shooting with confidence. The key to winning this for the Swifts, Cap, is turnover conversion. So from the very first ball, a turnover and they convert. First miss.
Well, what you'd hope here, Thwaites has just had her first miss, that Dad doesn't get into her head. We know that Laura Geitz has been on top of her the last couple of times they've played. She needs to get on with the job. Hard luck, Shani Layton, some great front defence. That'll be something she'll keep up for the game.
An early wobble from Gretel Tippett. Last year in the final, she shot 10 from 17. But of course, when you shoot the match winner, it doesn't matter.
That is causing the defense. Contact centre. Yes.
Nevins, circle edge. To Aitken. Doesn't even look to go to the post. And now the looping pass from Rebellion. Firebirds hit the front.
Well, that was an extremely fast centre pass taken by the Swifts. Then that might have been part of their plan to make sure that Simpson and Rebellion don't get in position to force the wide, set up the tactic we spoke about in the opener.
Getting worked over town by McMenamin. And and eventually her favourite move just popping out on the baseline. She knocks it down. Pettit with her first. Swatted away by Green. So that is one of the great matchups. And the other interesting matchup is Rob Wright starting Abby McCulloch. She's only started 4 games this season, and her one full game was that round 9 win against the Firebirds.
And Kelly was in the turnover Leighton. Here we go, this is what we talked about. They need to score from this. Swifts need to score from this. They need to treasure possession, work it down the court. It doesn't need to be fancy netball, it just needs to get there.
Because the opportunities defensively are so minimal, so they need to make the most of every turnover. Here's Turner, the rookie, to Green, to Pettit.
Was pull Laura Geitz just that millimetre off Caitlin Thwaites, and the ball was able to go straight to the post.
Get it from a fair distance, it falls short. It's the all important rebound, and the Swifts get another go. The 2-goal lead. It's been an electrifying start from the Swifts.
And look at the Swifts bench, Kel. They are up, they are cheering, they are into it. Everyone in this Swifts lineup is pumped for this afternoon.
On another turnover.
Swing attack, seven.
Just usually so composed, Kimra Valiant. She was really hurried on that pass.
Swing defense obstruction.
Pressure.
You're right, Rebellion, only 23 turnovers for the season. That is quite impressive, and an early one for her. She'll want to make sure she corrects that.
They've come to play, and they have thrown down the challenge to the home team. Courtside is Sarah Allen. Sarah.
Kath, you speak about this Swifts bench being so excited for their team. It's something you could sense in the pre-match. The Firebirds felt really relaxed, almost a little bit laid back, whereas the Swifts had this real energy and they were really excited for this match. And you can tell in the way that they've started the game. They came here to play today and they are pumped.
Oh, 4-goal lead early. No one saw that coming. They had a 6-goal lead in the third quarter last year in that final before losing by one.
That will be the big test for the Swifts this afternoon, Kel. If they get up, will they mentally be able to hang on? Will they be able to put the foot down and continue to build? They will have the nightmare of last year and what happened to them in their heads.
And the two captains tangle in the pocket. Green just backing back on tippy toes. Heard Geitz coming. That leaves Thwaites one out under the post. And she has got some real confidence in her shot early. What about that launch of a ball from Tippett? It needed to be precise, and she threaded it perfectly.
Yeah, gosh, risky ball at the start of a grand final, isn't it, to throw it from the centre there? But that just goes to show the confidence that Tippett and Aiken have in each other. Doing an absolute dream job on Nevin so far. Nearly every time Nevin's has gone to make a move, McCulloch's had her covered.
There goes that high ball again, though. So they're prepared to back it in. This is goal number 5 for Romelda Aiken, but more importantly, her 5,000th career goal. A milestone, a moment to savour for the superstar Jamaican shooter. The league's highest ever scoring shooter now has 5,000 to her name. She won't be worried about that right now. She'll be more concerned with this start for the Firebirds. Pettit rocks back from a fairway out and it falls up short. Well, that's 3 in a row. 3 high balls up. Aiken. Great
pass. It was a pass right out the back to Gretel Tippett. It went way off. You don't see that often, but the beauty of a Remelda Aiken is she's going to get the rebound.
This looks like a clear instruction. Let's isolate Aiken and Leighton and go for that long ball. Nevins looping it in again.
Contact weight.
Well, that's been one of the few times Nevins has got the ball close to circle edge and been able to find Aiken a lot easier. And those are the ones that she needs to sink. These are the conversions that the Swiss have been talking about. These are the turnovers they've got to capitalise on.
Oh, Revalian, crucial loose ball. Getting there first was Green. Those loose balls are going to be so important. Swifts must get to them first if they're to give themselves a chance. Let's get down to the Firebirds bench. Rosalie Jenkins, the coach, she's standing by with Sarah.
Rose, a slower start for your side. What do you put that down to?
Oh, look, it's just nerves. And we've just got to settle and get into some rhythm, but I think that we need some more pressure defensively right through the court, especially on our defence transfers, and work a little bit harder in attack. There's only one option. We need two.
How do you get Nevins into the game more? McCulloch's got the better of her so far.
Oh, look, she's just got to keep working. It's, you know, the first quarter, and it's four-quarter effort.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
It's a great point that Sarah picked up on the Nevins-McCulloch matchup. McCulloch played on in the first three quarters in the grand final last year. At three-quarter time, Nevins didn't have a single goal assist. And then McCulloch went to the bench. Nevins came into the contest, and that's when they launched their fight back.
Of the Sydney game as well. McCulloch completely took Nevins out of the game, and that was them on track for a win. Oh, Revillian, you do not see this very often. Two early mistakes. Must have the nerves. Very unlike her.
Brain fade, not once, but twice. She's been the player of the final series so far. From the coach, they are nervous. They tightened up against the Southern Steel in the last quarter last week, got out of jail just. And this has been a tight, nervous start from the home side.
Kim Green is driving so strong into that attack, and she is just putting her head down, and she is going. That ball is going to go to her. It doesn't matter if Laura Geis is coming flying at it. She's just going to take it. She's so determined this afternoon.
And we're six goals apiece down in this end between the shooters. So Susan Pettit has scored nearly as many goals as Romelda, who's on seven. It's extraordinary.
Inside. Centre contact.
Footwork call and she doesn't hear it.
Again, just in that perfect position. All she needs to do is put the pressure on constantly. Front position, front position. Just going to put a little bit of doubt in the feeders' heads. Only needs one or two to spray over the baseline. It gives the Swifts an opportunity.
Well, Romelda Aiken has gone cold in this first quarter. Leighton and the umpire just exchanging some words, wanting clarification. Shani Leighton. Her season average is 45. She had 57 last week against the Steel. She cannot bite a goal. In 9 years of the ANZ Championship, I've never seen this.
Well, Kel, that radar will need to come back, and it'll need to come back quick. Rosalie Jenke has not tinkered with her shooting circle this whole season, aside from the two games that Gretel Tippett has been out. She hasn't had the practice with the bench. She needs Aiken to make sure that radar gets on and gets on quick.
Contact goalkeeper, Becca, beside her.
Blakes has got her eye in up the other end. She's presenting hard. She's in a positive frame of mind. Oh, and it's picked off again. Quick hands by Pettit. Nevins wasn't even expecting that ball. Turner through the legs of McCulloch. It's scrappy. It's pressure netball. Error-riddled stuff. Leighton comes out fighting.
Inside.
And she'll be Needs to stand out of play here. So Turner, a complete mismatch with Romelda under the post. Can she land her first attempt? She does. And that's better by the Jamaican.
Well, the Swifts attackers, Langman and Green, are just putting their head down and they are driving. They know that the contacts and the physicality are going to come from both Rebellion and Simpson, and they are prepared to take it.
So, Wright's taunting. Pettit happy to play the mind games. At just the one attempt so far. She is yet to score a goal. Carrying the load, as we've seen so much this season, is Aitken.
I'd like to see Tippett take some of those shots. She's going to have to at some stage in the game. Like we saw last year, she ended up with the ball in her hands to win the game. She needs to get herself in there a little bit earlier.
A minute and a half to go before quarter time. The Firebirds have only trailed once, as you can see, and it was one game they lost over in New Zealand to the Southern Steel. This is unfamiliar territory for the defending champs. And that's an easier passage to the post. So the final minute of the 2016 grand final in this first quarter. New South Wales Swifts off to a flyer.
Well, contact, defensive contact. Caitlin Thwaites there. She's doing her best to stay strong against the physicality of a guy, but she's got to be careful not to retaliate.
Tippett launching that long ball. Aitken from a fair way out, and the rebound by Turner. Yes, it'll come back. It'll be a Swifts ball, and they've got time to set it up here. Leighton to start down back to Turner, to McCulloch, who's done the job in the first quarter on Nevins. Langman. So loud in here, I'm not sure they know how much time's left before we hear that quarter time whistle.
Well, contact on the arm, called by the umpire on Guyton. Thwaites will have another shot at it.
And denied that goal. And after 60 minutes, it'll come down to little moments like that. But the New South Wales Swifts have made an early statement in the 2016 Grand Final. Catch us if you can. It's the Swifts 15, the Firebirds 12.
He gets still a bit stuck on the body as he's setting up on the centre pass. The way to sit in front of her and then move early. So then you'll keep playing with the umpire, because clearly, like I reckon Jono, like he's probably pickier. So we've got to make sure we're a little bit more off the body, a little bit more, stay clean on it though, but keep contesting. Best contest ball though on it, then we're good though. Look for the opportunity for it. You know, it's got to get yourself.
So Rob Wright there going straight to his two defenders. Quarter time in the season decider. It is the underdogs, the New South Wales Swifts, leading the favourites, the Queensland Firebirds, by 3 goals. It's been an absorbing battle so far, Kath Cox.
Well, for me, straight away, the shooting percentages. If you look down the Firebirds end, at the moment they're only shooting 60%. That needs to lift. The beauty for them is they've got 7. They're out-rebounding the Swifts, 7 rebounds to 2. They're going to need to do that if they're only shooting at 60%.
So Aitken has missed 7 goals in 15 minutes of netball, and Tippett, 1 attempt in the first quarter. So they've played some of their best netball in the last 2 weeks. They were poor in that first quarter, yet they trail by just 3.
Yeah, it's quite amazing, isn't it? If those two can get their act together, which they're going to need to do very quickly, then they're more than capable of getting away here. So Swifts will stay with them. They'll want to push them. They'll want to keep that down in their heads. They want to make sure that they don't get on top.
Well, we're hoping it would be a case of deja vu and we would play out a similar storyline to last year. So far, it's going to script. Firebirds with a real battle on their hands and turn into the second turn. And that's a high ball from Nevins. Really made it awkward, allowed Turner to come in from behind. They'll reset. Oh, Leighton was piggy in the middle. Leighton should knock this down.
Vantage breaking wing attack. Vantage obstruction.
Oh, great defence by the Firebirds in that mid-court area.
That's more like it. They just blocked up that top bit there. Made it a lot harder. Swiss having to retreat to the back. But like we say, they just need to make sure they keep possession. It doesn't matter if it goes back. They've just got to hang on to the ball.
Here's Laura Langman, her 137th ANZ Championship game and her last one. She's played six more than any others, and there's another turnover.
Well, again, they were just forced to retreat, forced to go all the way back to the centre third, and Nevins was there waiting for those scraps.
Courtside and keeping a close eye on the Firebirds this afternoon as they close to within one.
As you mentioned earlier, Gretel Tippett, one attempt, zero goals to her name. That whole quarter-time huddle was telling her to put her shots up, turn around, put them up, get involved in this match. They know they need more than one goal of hitting the scoreboard if they're a chance to win this game.
Tippett with a one-hander, if you don't mind, and we're all tied up.
Well, how will the Swiss respond here, Kel? They need to keep the drive. They need to just get back into that mode they were in that first quarter. They do start well. They can...
Oh, and again. They're just giving it to the opposition.
Well, that's been two attempts. The last two trips down the court, they've gone back to the centre third for help and they've thrown it to the opposition.
Passes like that can prove to be catastrophic. And it's so intense and tight. Here's Tippett again. The lookaway pass. Leighton swats it away, like a volleyball style almost. Well, it's scrappy. No one can treasure possession out there at the moment. For the first goal for Gretel Tippett in the 2016 Grand Final.
Goalkeeper.
Well, hit the lead at the 2-minute mark of this final, and they've trailed since then. Give them a two-goal buffer.
Banerjee's in the post.
Well, you can tell Aiken is spooked. She's taking a lot more time to put the shot up than she normally would. She's thinking about it an awful lot. She needs to turn, she needs to pop it up and just back herself.
And surely if you're a Swiss player out there and you're watching that, it gives you confidence.
Without doubt, what they do need to do is just persist with those rebounds because Aiken is such a great rebounder, but there's cracks appearing. They need to capitalise. Around the circle edge, Langman and Green then making sure they're available so the ball doesn't have to go back to the centre third. Beautiful feed from Langman just underneath the defender's arm.
And suddenly we've got an arm wrestle. We're going goal for goal. Langman came out hunting, left Aitken all alone. She's just lost all rhythm, all timing on the shot. She is buckling here. That's better. Aiken has missed 10 shots.
Well, I'm assuming that was a break call. There's so much happening out there, Kill. It's hard to keep up. But 10 shots in just over one quarter is quite amazing. Goes to show how many attempts she does have, though. So, Ronaldo, just turn, shoot it, back yourself.
Moment. They're the other team can really control this game. The Swifts had control of it early. And now there's a real tug of war going on out there. And both want it on their terms. Scrappy, the ball almost pinballing around in that midcourt. For two in a row. The post, and the coach can't believe it. Kathy's been a superstar shooter in this game for a long time. How do you get yourself out of a funk?
Well, it's interesting you say that, Kel, because the play before that shot, Romelda Aiken came out of the circle a long way. She's trying to get away from the goal post. She's almost got the yips. What she needs to do is stay under the post, do the game that she does so well, back herself. Don't start disappearing, getting away from the ball.
Well, have you ever seen that?
It was a replay call. She complete air ball, but she took the ball again herself, so it counts as a replay.
And now the Swifts hit the front. It is an absorbing battle. 9 minutes to play before halftime, and the Swifts lead it by one. Their coach is Rob Wright. He's on the bench with Bianca.
Rob, a great start so far. How's the match unfolded in your eyes?
Yeah, look, I think when we keep our movement and keep some depth happening, then I think we've been really good in attack. It's when we get a little bit still or a bit, we end up on top of each other, then we can't use our speed, and that's what we try and rely on. We've just got to continue contesting ball. Like I always think against the super talls, you have to try and keep winning ball. That's probably just a little bit misplaced. A lot of ball's going to get over you. You just got to stay cool and calm and win what you can get.
Now, defensively, I think the Swiss girls are doing a great job keeping them up high. Are you just daring them to put that big ball into Romelda and Shani's going to get a hand to it eventually?
Trouble is they keep daring. Look, we are daring them because at the end of the day, look, if it gets down there, look, she's incredibly good and, you know, we have to try and stop all earlier. So look, that's the plan and we'll see if we can keep getting some.
You've got to be happy with that goal. Enjoy the rest of the game.
No worries. Thanks very much.
Is trying to enjoy it, but I'm not sure he is. So here is Aiken. She is the story of this second quarter. Trying to inch herself closer to the post. She's gone cold. The occasion has got to her, and now she's handballing off to Tippett. You rarely see that.
Well, I would be concerned if I was Rosalie Jenkins seeing that happen. You never see that happen in the game. Romelda Aiken giving up a shot underneath the post. What does Jenki do? What's going through her mind now? She's very rarely used her bench this year.
Well, Chelsea Lemke has played just the 3 games this year for the Queensland Firebirds for a total of 21 goals for the entire season. So this is not a team that turns to its bench, particularly in the most important contest of the year. So Ravelli in the high ball, the wonderful take, the big right arm goes up. Now the right arm is heavy. It is shaking at the moment. It feels like cement and it doesn't want to take the shot.
All of a sudden you've got the rookie, you've got Gretel Tippett, who really last year I think averaged 50-something percent for the season. That's not good enough. You've got her in there as your go-to shooter. Things aren't looking great.
That's a scary thought. Things aren't looking great, Kath, and it's all tied up. 21 goals apiece. Quates hasn't missed in this second quarter. She goes 5 from 5. Pettit is 2 from 2. They're doing their job.
Defensive pickups. If you continue to score, it's going to be at least a draw. So that's what they need to do.
Green in the pocket. Lovely take. So much athleticism. The bounce pass, superb. Plenty of speed on that. Into Pettit, on the pocket, on the baseline, and it's a held ball. So 5 minutes to play before half time. Layton strips her of it, and it's not legal.
Wow, again, that's three in a row. She's had a penalty pass, a shot underneath the post and given it off to Tippett. I would love to see Romelda take those. She needs to get herself back in the game, and she's certainly not going to do that if she's giving up her shots.
It's catchy. They've officially got the yips, the Queensland Firebirds. This bench, they're up into it. They sense the moment. Maybe they need to make a move. 5 minutes to play before half-time.
Well, defensively, the Firebirds are doing everything right. It is hard work for the Swifts down there. They've just got to keep their drives going. They've got to cut through their middle. We spoke about the tactic at the start of the game, trying to force them wide. Obviously, the Swifts have just got to commit to that middle channel.
Put the visitors in front. Swaits knocks it down from mid-range. This is just unbelievable to watch. So we've had five lead changes in this quarter alone. 24 goals apiece.
I tell you, in this moment, I am feeling for Romelda Rake, and I've been there. And you feel the tightness in your chest when you get the ball, and you're nervous, and you don't want to shoot, and you just don't have the confidence to let it go because you just don't know if it's going to go in.
Bad scraping, no defense.
So which side will take the lead into the halftime break? Can Romelda regather? Regroup. A cheeky little smile. She's giving her coach heart palpitations at the moment.
Great ball, Kim Green. Caitlin Thwaites had a beautiful hold on Laura Guyatt, but what Green did was put the ball away from Laura Guyatt. So she almost turned Caitlin Thwaites inside out to take it, but she takes it undefended.
Contact. Goalkeeper. Contact, all defence. Contact, goalkeeper, both for five.
Purple fans in a Brisbane Entertainment Centre let out a collective sigh. They are riding every Romelda shot out there at the moment. Here's Green, all alone in the pocket. Contact against McMenamin.
Valiant, beautiful screen she set up in the midcourt, then just allowed Simpson to run off her in the side and take the ball. Almost effortless down the court then. Love to see the Swifts put a little bit more defensive pressure on them and slow them up.
Firebirds back in front, a minute and a bit to play. Can't remember the last time that this Queensland team, the all-conquering Queensland team, has played this poorly, has missed this amount of shots. To give them a two-goal buffer, a little bit of breathing space before half-time, and maybe she's back. Maybe, just maybe, they lead it by two with a minute to play.
Great front shot, cut, Susan Pettit. Just nudging her way through. It is very, very willing, very physical in that shooting circle, but she's just dropping her shoulder and running through it beautifully.
Important passage of play.
for the Swifts. Green into Pettit for another goal. Look at that bench. Look how much it means to them. They are engaged. They are switched on. It's been a solid start by the Swifts. It's had plenty of drama. Well, she can't buy one from under the post, but she lands a long bomb, and that'll be halftime here at the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. The Queensland Firebirds will take the lead after putting out what has been maybe one of their more poor performances for 2016. Romelda Aitken had a case of the staggers. She regathered late, and they will take a two-goal lead into the main break. It is the Firebirds 29, leading the Swifts 27. Bianca.
Kim, great start so far. How are you going to stay in this game?
Yeah, I think just at critical times, just being super calm. I think, you know, we're getting a lot of ball, and the defender's doing such a great job for us. We just need to treasure that and, yeah, score.
What did you expect from the Firebirds attack? And there's been a lot of missed goals down there.
Yeah, look, I think the defensive pressure from us is, you know, really putting them under the pressure. So I think, you know, at the end of the day, we just need to get what we can get and then score off it as well, like get it to our shooters.
All the best for the second half. Sarah is now with Romelda.
Thanks, B. Well, Romelda, we haven't seen you like that before. 14 misses. What's going through your head when you're looking at the ring?
I think I'm just overthinking the shot. I'm thinking about always getting the hit from Shani, but I think it's coming back in now. In the last couple of goals, I'm starting to find my feet. So just need to just take a deep breath and just not overthink it.
It feels like the whole team needed to do that at the start. Did you not come in prepared enough for this match?
Oh, yeah, we were super prepared. And, you know, Swifts won't be coming out any easier than they are coming out at the moment. And I think we just need to just play our style of game and just not get caught up in whatever they're putting out there.
Best of luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Well, there's just two goals in it here at Brisbane Entertainment Centre. This is netball at its best. 30 minutes down, 30 minutes to go. Don't go anywhere.
Patrick was the love of Nina's life. 8:40 Wednesday.
Patrick's ex-wife.
It's the Bombshell.
I've been debating whether or not I should or shouldn't have this conversation with you.
Nina didn't see coming.
Something to do with Patrick? Yep. Okay. Here goes.
New Offspring, following The Bachelor, Wednesday on 10.
This is our country. Our growing population. This is our leader. These are our colours. And our traditional dance. We speak our own language. These are our warriors. This is our army. And together, we are the Netball Nation.
If you're made to think you're just not good enough,
bench.
And all you can think is, prove them wrong. If you can take hit after hit, dig deep, and never give up, if you can ride.
Halftime here in Brisbane. It's the 2016 ANZ Championship Grand Final. The Queensland Firebirds one win away from back-to-back titles, but the Swifts one way away. Win away from righting the wrongs of last year. And Shani Layton, we've said all year, well, she's a player that gets in your head. I think it's safe to officially declare, Kath Cox, that she is in Romelda Aitken's head. Have you ever seen her shoot like that as we have in the first 30 minutes here?
Never, and I don't know that we ever will again, but interesting to hear her even say at halftime that she is waiting for the hits from Shani Layton. That's putting her off her shot. She said it. She's admitted to it. Shani Layton is winning the battle.
Okay, take us through these numbers. What stands out?
Well, standing out for me is the shooting accuracy for the Firebirds. 63%. You don't ever see that. Goal attempts, 46. So they've got 13 more goal attempts than the Swifts at the moment. Rebounding, fortunately for the Firebirds, are well and truly out-rebounding the Swifts. They're at 14-3. Penalties have evened up a little bit.
So the Swifts with a super start. They absolutely flew out the blocks. They led by five, as many as five goals in that first quarter.
I can't help but think that maybe they should have made them pay a little bit more at this stage.
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? We're talking about how poorly the Firebirds attack end is playing, probably the worst we've ever seen them, but they're still up by two. The Swifts will be wondering what more they can possibly do to get in this game and get on top. They are playing well, though. They're playing nice and basic. They're letting the balls go. There's plenty of great drive in the attack end from Kim Green and Laura Langman. They just need more of it.
And all the talk, obviously, is about Leighton and Aitken. Romelda, well, she is jittery. She is nervy. She's scored 26 goals from 40 attempts. She missed 7 in the first quarter and she missed another 7 in the second.
It's quite remarkable, isn't it? And even if you just look at the spread, 26 goals to Romelda, only the 3 to Gretel Tippett. If Romelda's off her mark, Gretel Tippett needs to step up. She needs to be taking more than the 3 shots.
What about up the other end of the post? Another fascinating duel between Laura Geitz and Caitlin Thwaites. And the defensive tactics of Laura Geitz caught your eye this week. This is her last week against the Southern Steel.
Yeah, they did. They caught my eye for a few reasons. She's not going for a ball on a lot of occasions, just backing in. I won't use the word tunnelling, even though I just had, but she is getting up under her player. A lot of the time, all that does is cause a fumble, and that's all she needs to do. But she's a smart player. She's not doing anything that the umpires aren't letting her do. She starts the first half nice and easy, within the rules, and then lets it go a little bit in the second half. We're very interesting to see if she uses the same sort of tactics in the second half.
It'll be very interesting indeed. Just the second half, full stop. We've got one half left in the ANZ Championship before we bid it farewell, but it's not the end of netball for 2016. Plenty of internationals coming your way. Tickets on sale this Friday for the Constellation Cup between Australia and New Zealand. Championship grand final, the last one in 2016. This place is rocking. 10,000 in the Brisbane Entertainment Centre. Who will be raising the trophy aloft in 30 minutes' time? It is Laura Langman, the 30-year-old New Zealander. She moved across the Tasman, made the controversial move to come here to win a second title. She's in for a big last 30 minutes here as Simpson kicks pocket of Green and the Firebirds are away into Romelda. What sort of frame of mind is she in? She scores. Look at that, the speed. Kim Green did not even see that coming. Leighton went out looking for the intercept and Aitken goes bang bang to start the third.
That's the sort of lift that she needs. Just needs to back herself. She's got two early ones. Hopefully that's going to put her in the right frame of mind for the rest of this quarter.
If you had the chance to speak to her at halftime, Kath, what would you have said to her?
I would have just said turn and shoot it. You can tell her shot is different. She's taking a lot longer to let it go, which is just making her think about it a lot longer. Normally turns, bangs, lets it go. I would just remind her to do the same thing.
Well, here's the defence by the Firebirds we spoke about in the pre-match. Trying to keep the Swifts wide. Trying to slow them down. They're almost unstoppable in that middle channel. And that is a long bomb landed by Pettit. Aitken's protecting the backspace. She wants it over the top. Here it comes. Make it 3-from-3 to start the third. She's back.
Well, you can see Susan Pettit doing a lot of the directing down court. Kim Green looked at her and she just pointed away, looked at Langman. Wasn't ready for the ball, just saw a better option. She's smart down there. She's doing a lot of the playmaking, even if she doesn't have ball in hand.
And they remain within three here, the Swifts. We also spoke about in the pre-match, Kath, that Caitlin Thwaites cannot beat Geitz over four quarters, that Geitz really wears her down. Trail by 4 goals, the Swifts. A
at what point, and it's nowhere near panic stations, does Rob Wright roll the dice? At what point does he say, you know what, Steph Wood's done this for us before. She's the X factor. She's the wild card. We might bring her in just to mix things up a little bit.
Well, look, I'd give Thwaites a little bit longer purely because her season average is 31 goals. Up against the Firebirds, it's only 22. She's got 15 at halftime. She's on track to having one of her better games against Laura Weiss. I'd give her another quarter, see how she goes.
Well, he's a tactical mastermind, and he's brain over. Oh, tip it! Not quite. Falling out of court, little fadeaway. Three goals from five attempts for Gretel Tippett. Oh, guys came out hunting. And Thwaites was up to the challenge there.
Well, the Swifts are being smart, knowing full well the Firebirds are trying to push them into the pockets. They're almost taking that run, dangling the carrot, forking the pass, and then just popping it into the goal shooter. They're playing smart. They're playing into the hands of the Firebirds.
Thwaites nets it. Back-to-back goals for her.
Again, just in such great front position. So unlucky that she's not coming up with these balls more often, but it will come. All she's got to get is one or two little wins along the way.
And now four from four in this third quarter, a completely different player.
Bates contact, get offside, Tinker.
Bates, on to loose ball. Oh, the umpire has blown his whistle. It'll come back. She's had her moments, but she's threatening and threatening, and you just sense that the crowd's almost willing her to come out flying, launch herself for an intercept. And that's exactly what Leighton does. The timing was off, and it'll be 5 for 5 for Aitken, and they've got a little break.
Turner and Leighton are very, very close to getting an intercept here. Leighton's coming for the fly, but as the ball's released into Aitken, Turner is changing the pace, and she's getting in there and covering her. Any minute now, she's going to pick up one of those passes.
Yeah, we've got the two best defenders in the world at the moment. It's Gotts and Leighton, and one of them will pounce. You can just sense it. Let's get down court side and keeping a close eye on the Swifts, Bianca Chatfield.
There's a huge battle going on between Simpson and Green. Keep a very close eye on them. There's no love lost between the two of them. It's physical, and they both want that edge of the circle first.
Off the hands of Pettit. Both teams just trying to absorb the defensive pressure that's been applied. Just sense there's still this real tug of war. One team trying to get desperately on top of the other, and they can't. Leighton slaps it to McCulloch, who gives it to Langman, who gives it to Green to Pettit. Forced to slow up now, back to Langman. Turnover conversion, those two words will be rattling in their brains right now. Turnover conversion.
Gosh, Gabby Simpson is an impressive player to watch. She is working overtime, riding her opponent, riding anyone that comes near her. Her change of pace and her last few steps onto the ball is amazing.
A little shake of the head from that. She didn't like the call, didn't agree with it.
The toe on the line, so an incorrect throw-in taken there, and that one is a coach killer. We're speaking about how important it is to score off any sort of turnover you get from the Firebirds. Those ones are the one percenters. Those ones you should not be giving away.
Gee, that hurts. It's moments like that that might come back to haunt them. Too big and too strong. Aitken launching herself over the top of Leighton. And they just hold on to that lead. The tells us how dominant they are in their hometown. The Firebirds haven't lost at home since round one last year. Looking to make it 19 in a row.
Oh, God, she's getting all the important rebounds down there, isn't she? Caitlin Thwaites just missing the last couple. And God's all over them.
Time to step up. Guides. And then Leighton. Suddenly goals hard to come by. 7 goals apiece in this third quarter. 7 minutes to play.
Again, beautiful vision. Susan Pettit just balked the pocket, the pass into the pocket. Just brought Guides off the body a little bit, managed to get it straight under the post. She's been very smart with the ball down there, knowing how physical the Firebirds lineup can be.
The coach, Rosalie Jenke, thinks of that. She's standing by with Sarah.
Rose, what was your message to Romelda at halftime?
Look, she just needs to really relax on it and just be calm, and that she's done this all year and that she's, just needs to keep working.
Do you have the confidence that you know she'll get herself into the game regardless of what happens in the next few minutes?
Look, I think she's a champion of the game and she's still, getting her rebounds, so there's no problems there.
You're yelling out to the girls that you want them to work harder. You're not happy with their work rate at the moment?
I think that we just need more offers in attack. We need to be continually working.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Well, very good point, Rosalie Jenke. Romelda Aiken is still getting her rebounds. As the Firebirds let one spray over the baseline, but she is still getting the rebound. She is a great rebounder. Really, if she gets a rebound after a miss and gets another shot and eventually gets it in, it's almost like she didn't miss it.
It's just so much pressure in this contest that I feel like none of the players have been able to really get comfortable. Seeing so many unforced errors. Aiken, amazing.
Letting that ball go into the corner pocket. Whilst the Firebirds are forcing them there, the Swifts are happy to take it and still create something from there.
That was a big offensive rebound from Thwaites. That is a rather large wingspan that you do need to get the ball past. So it's the Firebirds one by one. Oh, layup from Aiken. It's swatted by Turner. Gives it to Leighton. And now they're away, the Swifts. Must convert the turnovers. To Susan Pettit, a foundation player to make it level. We are tied up with 4 minutes to go in this third quarter.
Well, smart work, Maddie Turner, too. She knew she couldn't take that rebound two-handed. Just a little tap back to Shani Leighton.
The heat's rising. It's getting louder. Pettit, cool. All the experience in the world. 54 tests for Australia. More than 100 games for the Swifts. One of two foundation players, along with Green. Leighton nearly takes Tippett's head off.
She's been looking for it. Shani Leighton was eyeing that up about 3 passes earlier. She's coming. Chapfield was so right. The matchup, Simpson and Kim Green, is something to watch. They are such similar players, both so powerful, so fast, and so explosive.
A
she does best. And Chatfield sidelines.
Keep an eye on Shani Layton and Maddie Turner. It's hard for Shani to get up for those rebounds, so she's using Maddie Turner's shoulder to push up and give her a little bit more height to get up higher. Diva Mentor and I used to try it all the time. Not sure if it's allowed, but it's worth a try.
Yeah, and perfect example. We saw her ready to launch, using that left arm wrench and just resting it on Turner.
Well, there's no real reason it wouldn't be allowed. Surely, Bianca, she's not lifting herself off of the opposition player using her own.
New rule this year, no goaltending. And, oh, and then the block from Gotts. It certainly does seem legal. So the Swifts just holding on, doing everything they possibly can to remain in touch. It's only a goal the difference.
It's almost like the Swifts have spent the last couple of weeks practicing the feed from the corner pockets. If that's where they're going to get forced, they're going to work on the best delivery. So far, they're doing it fairly easily.
41 goals apiece. 1 minute to play before three-quarter time. Desperate stuff. The call goes against Green, and there's some bumping and body contact between the two.
Out of construction.
McCulloch flies through.
Well, we're getting another missed feed. Really was quite an easy pass, and just threw it straight to McCulloch.
Swifts had possession, Firebirds had possession. Now it's the Swifts' chance to take the lead before three-quarter time. Susan Pettit delivers coolly. She means business. So when the Firebirds and the Swifts lead at three-quarter time, they're yet to lose a game. It's going to be the Swifts that take the lead. The Swifts are going to take the lead into three-quarter time. The scene is set. What a game. What a rivalry. Who wants it more? It's the Swifts 42, the Firebirds 41. Don't go anywhere. Get a cup of tea. You've got a couple of minutes. And sit back down and enjoy this one with us. Three-quarter time in a pulsating grand final between the New South Wales Swifts and the Queensland Firebirds. Swifts lead it by one. Kath Cox, what do these numbers tell us?
Oh, look, again, from the same as halftime, the shooting accuracy, 64%. You just don't see that from the Firebirds. Well and truly out winning the rebounds, though, 18 to the 5. Creeping up a little bit with the penalties as well. Firebirds will need to keep that in check. They don't want to give the Swifts anything easy.
Tippett didn't score a goal in the third quarter. Aitken scored 12. She had six misses. When the Swifts lead at three-quarter time, they haven't lost it. And that woman on screen wants it. She wants it bad. They all do. 14 players. What a mindset. Let's see what this last ever quarter has got in store for us. Have the Swifts got the legs? They've been on the road for the last 3 weeks.
Another beautiful feed, Pettit, just putting the ball. Beautiful rebound, Laura Guides. Such great feeds going in. They're the ones that need to be finished off.
If you're a player out there, Kat, what is your mindset? What are you telling yourself? And it's so tense. There's so much drama. You can barely hear yourself think.
The girls will be tired. It's been a tussle and it's been a hard three quarters so far. They will be reminding themselves it is 15 minutes. There is 15 minutes left of this game, of their season, of this ANZ Championships. Leave absolutely nothing in the tank.
All those passes have gone wayward, but not that one. It was pinpoint. Firebirds back in front. What an emotional roller coaster we're riding here. 60 minutes of the most thrilling netball you could ever wish to see. And for the second year in a row, we are going to go down to the wire. Nevins McCulloch. McCulloch has been so good this afternoon. So good on Nevins. She has done her job.
Absolutely done her job. Another stroke of genius by coach Rob Wright. And look at the pressure the Firebirds defence end is creating. Swifts have had to retreat two or three occasions to find their way into the circle.
Waits with five misses. She shot 21. She makes it 22. It wasn't pretty, but it was effective.
Pressure over that shot is just unbelievable. To even get it out of the hand looks like a challenge.
Seriously, who'd be a shooter?
Not me anymore.
What frame of mind is she in? Two from two to start the last.
I still don't think Romelda Rakin's feeling confident with her shot. She's taking an awful long time to let it go, which is very uncharacteristic for her. The Swifts can continue to put the pressure on that. I think we'll start to see some cracks in that shot again.
Every tiny turnover is massive.
Wing attack. Yes.
Kim Green had an awful lot to say to the umpire then about Gabby Simpson using her body. McCulloch, another brilliant pickup. She is doing more than enough.
Gee, they're feeling it out there. They are nervous, they are jittery, and McCulloch.
Centre, obstruction.
Fantastic, she has stood tall. To Pettit. Fights with the all-important rebound. So the last two attacks, they have not been able to score the Swifts. Just sense that they are clinging on here. Holding on for dear life, and the Firebirds desperate to put their foot down.
Well, Leighton, she thought about going and then realised she'd left Aiken all under the post by herself. Quickly retreated. Fortunately, the pass a little bit overcooked and over her head. Smiths have ended up with it. Well, Caitlin Thwaites now heading out of the circle as they're struggling to get it down. We haven't seen that happen a whole heap.
Swift's looking to level up. Let's get down to their coach, who would be feeling this as well. Rob Wright, the coach of the Swifts. And he's with Bianca.
Rob, I promise I'll keep it short. What did you say to the girls at three-quarter break?
Oh, look, probably just about trying to continue what I thought we did quite well in the third quarter. Got some movement happening. Got some movement in attack, and I thought we actually were able to keep forcing them wide and just putting some pressure on defensively. So,
and a great tactical move starting with McCulloch. She's had a great game.
Yeah, look, she's come terrific. She's a fighter, and I think she's always been quite a good matchup on Nevins. But gosh, we've got another 10 minutes of this.
I'll let you go. Try and enjoy the next 10 minutes.
So Susan Pettit, goal number 22 in that all-important stat. When she scores 21 or more, the Swifts have not lost this year. All tied up again. 44 goals apiece, 10 to play.
I was going to say, the fact that they were up at three-quarter time, and now the Susan Pettit factor have come into it. They're not going to lose the game, are they, Kel? It's all working in their favour.
You're brave, you're brave.
Hold time.
Let's get down to the Queensland Firebirds coaching bench. Rosalie's with Sarah.
Rose, how confident are you that this team can get across the line in the dying minutes of this match?
Oh, look, they've been there before, and, you know, they've just got to really settle and really be composed. And, look, it's going to go down to the wire. You know, the best team will win on the day.
You said in the quarter-time huddle that you think the Swiss will tighten up. Do you feel like your finals experience will really get you across the line?
Hopefully. Look, it's a cracker of a game. It's a great game between two great teams. And there's a lot of pressure out there, and you're seeing that right now because, you know, both teams want it so much. So, you know, it's a great spectacle for our sports, and we've got to just, you know, keep working. Can't afford to get tight.
Thanks, Rose.
Thank you.
Okay,
she sounds laid back, but I think her tummy would be churning right now.
To it, just got enough on that occasion. It is getting so physical out there. Every single ball it's taken.
So the Firebirds have scored five of the first seven goals in this last quarter. Shani's bellowing. I'm not sure anyone can hear her out there. It is deafening. 10,000 at Brisbane Entertainment Centre. Will they be the eighth player? Will they get them over the line? That's an ambitious ball from Revalian. And a lucky let off for the Firebirds.
The side of goal defence. Thank you.
The staggers again. And that's a lucky break. That is a big let off. They've got a three-goal lead with eight to play. What about the body language of the world's two best defenders? Leighton is menacing. She's prowling. She's trying to intimidate. She's vocal at the other end. Wright's just bouncing up and down. She's quiet. She's calm. And she's in control. She sets them up. Defensively to McMenamin, to Nevins. Revalian forced to drive and cut, eventually gets the ball off Langman. Tippett to Aitken. This will test her. They've landed a few blows early in this last quarter, the Firebirds. They're trying to break the resistance of the Swifts. Well, she couldn't get one under the post all afternoon. She's found her radar from way out. A five-goal lead, and it makes life very difficult for the Swifts. There's still a long time to play.
Well, interesting to see Renata Aitken completely change her style of game to get herself back in. She's out of the circle. She's on the move. She's defending the centre pass.
Charlie hits the deck. Tippett with the pass. Into Nevins. A little physical there from Langman. Aitken will be the target. Here she is, Leighton in front. Leighton pounces.
Those are the ones we're talking about, Kel. She's not going to get a lot of them, but one or two will start to come as she continues to put the pressure on.
Bunch of side centre.
Pettit. Keeping the minute. Great stuff from Susan Pettit. She's got 23 goals. They can't afford to panic. In the back of their mind, what happened here last year? They led by six. They lost by one. Drakes was on. Instead, Langman, the preferred option is Pettit. She's playing a lone hand.
Well, Susan Jackson Pett have been smart play the last couple. Both Kim Green and Laura Langman have been taken out of that attack end a lot. That middle channel's not there, so Caesar Pettit is taking it on herself.
For a second goal of the last quarter, Tippett is 2 from 2 in the last. Headed again. And the New South Wales Swifts with a miss, the all-important rebound from Thwaites. And they are proving hard to kill. A large contingent of the Red Army have made their way from Sydney. I'm not sure they'll have any nails left at the minute. Four and a bit minutes. 2 goals the margin. The cool Jamaican.
Another beautiful feed. Kim Green again throwing the ball away from where Guides is defended. Caitlin Thwaites is doing an awful good job to turn herself inside out and take them.
Continue to knock on the door here, the Swifts. Paige Hadley left of screen, an Australian diamond, hasn't had any court time. We haven't seen any changes so far. The game is in the balance. It's everything we'd hoped for. Four to play in the last ever ANZ Championship final. Who's going to stand up in the moment? Who wants it more?
Don't use that language at me. That's a warning.
Being told to settle down. Get too emotional in these moments?
You absolutely can get too emotional. They need to just keep cool heads, Shani in particular. Yes, she's going to get hyped up. We see her, we know she plays like that, but she can't afford to get too physical and start going for things. She needs to be in play. Well, Kim Green, of all people, the captain's just thrown the ball away. She will be working her butt off to get this one back.
Oh no, they go the long ball. It'll be Swifts. It was risky. Often Aiken can make a bad pass look good. But that was a bad pass, and it keeps the Swifts alive.
And they've got plenty of time. 3 minutes is an awful lot of time to turn this around. They don't need to rush too much.
They have slogged this out. Just 2 goals left. Can the Firebirds close it out? Or will they tighten up? 5 down halfway through this quarter.
The goalkeeper. Beside her.
And they're trying to fly home. Firebirds lifting when it matters most.
Well, a score here. They just need a turnover. And they've got their centre pass. They are well within grasp of winning this game, the Swifts. They need a turnover and they need it now.
What an epic finale. 10,000 gripped by this. The Purple Army finding their voice. If they score here, it makes life tough for the Swifts. Tippett doesn't want to take it. Aitken. A big deep breath. And it's clutch. It's clutch from Aitken. It's 3 goals and it makes things very difficult for the Swifts.
Pausing, centre third.
Wait.
Yes, centre third.
Unbearable tension throughout this match. Everyone's poised, ready to capture this final moment, but who will win it with a minute to play? They're desperate, the Swifts. The long bomb, live or die by the long bomb, and Pettit with the long bomb. 2 goals, 5 minutes possession. Do they soak up the seconds?
Absolutely not. They need to score. They cannot.
It's a turnover. The Swifts still with time. They'll get the centre pass if they can score here. Surely not. Nerves of steel. 25 seconds left on the clock.
Championship is still alive. We are going into extra time.
Lead with the house. We're
delivered. We are tied after 60 minutes. It is 54 goals apiece. A dead heat, a stalemate, a draw. Unbelievable drama. This is crazy, mind-blowing stuff. And a replay of that final frantic minute. Geitz was called. It gave Thwaites the shot by Cathcock.
Unlucky. She was in great front position. Looked like she had two hands on the ball, but there was a basic contact call that the umpire saw there. Caitlin Thwaites just given the extra shot.
So for the 20th time in ANZ Championship history, we are into extra time. We play 7 minutes, we have a 1 minute break, and we play another 7 minutes. After that, we're into double extra time. Surely not. Here we go. They are playing on fumes out there.
That's exactly right, Kel. You have to remember these girls have just put their bodies on the line for 60 minutes. Now they've been asked to find another 14. To the challenge.
Cathew not only played your on-court in Delhi for that double extra time, famous, wasn't it almost a victory against the Silver Ferns? It was a loss. But what are those moments like? How much does it push you and extend you as an athlete? And mentally, how do you get around this?
Well, fortunately for me, I came on at half-time. But these girls, there's been no changes. So they're now asked to basically find another quarter after what has been a torrid affair already. They need to dig deep. They are fit. What they need to do probably more than anything is keep mentally in the game. And Laura Geitz is also up to the challenge.
Just repeating the play, there's 7 minutes here. We have a break, we change ends, and another 7 minutes. So they've got another 14 minutes in them. Long ball in Poken. What a leap.
Battered breaking goal attack.
Battered contact centre.
The Firebirds now inch their way in front. Let's get down courtside to our commentators, Sarah Allen and also Bianca Chatfield.
I was down listening into the Swiss bench at that break. Sharni Layton was trying to take in some deep breaths just to calm herself down. Keep an eye on Lauren Moore, has been warming up, so has Paige Hadley. This is the time they may need fresh legs.
Meanwhile, in the Queensland Firebirds bench, really calm again, which they've been all match. Their strength and conditioning coach, Brinley Abad, yelled over the fence, back your fitness, girls. You're fitter than this other side. So interesting insight from him. And what we noticed as they came off at that last whistle was that the Swiss were pumped that they went into extra time and the Firebirds were fuming. So it'll be interesting to see how that mindset changes going through the next few minutes.
And which coach, if any, rolls the dice first and says, that's it, we are going with fresh legs, Kat?
Well, it's a big call, isn't it, Kel? These are the girls that have delivered for 60 minutes for you. This is your preferred starting seven. Yes, fresh legs would be ideal, but do you want to put them out there in what is going to be a humongous pressure cooker?
Pressure cooker, indeed. It's been a pressure cooker from the opening minute. And again, the radar goes off.
You can't forget, too, that the bench is just as physically exhausted. They have been up. They have been willing every pass to get to its target, taking every shot themselves. They will be just as physically worn out.
Yeah, come on, and you'll be absolutely emotionally spent. So which team remains energised here?
With the keeper. Okay. Construction goal defense. That's it.
And the Firebirds crack it open first. They've got that 3-goal lead. We have had 14 lead changes in this decider.
Swiss need some ball side options. That was an awfully long pass for Laura Langman to have to throw from the throw-in. They need to get players closer to a running ball side.
Jackson. Susan Pettit now with her 30th goal and 7 misses. She has outscored Caitlin Floats, who has 27. What a great ball. And Aitken does it again. Usually say that she scores with authority. I don't think we've been able to say that at all this afternoon. From the start, nervous, jittery.
What a beautiful ball, Kim Green. Laura Langman driving to the top of the circle. Kim Green just opens up the shoulder and lets a beautiful, strong shoulder pass go.
So 2 minutes left before our first break in this extra time. They will change ends and there'll be another 7 minutes to play. Pettit. From long range, this will test her. The rebound falls away of. Quakes can't keep it in play.
Look at the calm from Laura Geitz. Slowly went to take the ball, almost just telling everyone, just relax, we've got plenty of time to do this. Puts her hand up. Just relax, guys, let's just finish this game off.
Got a 4-goal lead here, the Firebirds. We're going to look at the biggest leads all afternoon. The Swifts were up by 5 in the first quarter. And then the Firebirds up by 5 in the last when the Swifts were able to mount a challenge and get back and level at full time.
Obstruction.
And they closed the gap again.
28 seconds left. That has been the longest quickest seven minutes. All the players will be thankful for that, that's for sure. Looking forward to getting into this next one.
It feels like time standing still out there at the moment. It feels like we've been playing this match for an eternity. And a miss from Tippett, the all-important rebound from the Swifts. So here we go.
Got to send it. 6 seconds. You've got to get it out there.
Hold time. When the team sets deliberate. No, back there. That's a caution.
Must move it quickly, Langman. To Pettit. And that will not count. So the Swifts deny.
extra time, if you follow my drift. We've got a minute to pause, and how do both groups handle it here before we swap hands for this final 7 minutes?
Well, look, I think they'll just be going back to their tactics that were the same at the obviously the same at the start of the game. We can see here in the corner of my eye, though, Steph Wood warming up at goal attack. Will that be Susan Pettit to the bench or Caitlin Thwaites? Don't know if Rob Wright will make that change or if she's just making sure she stays warm, but I'd imagine the address to the side, stick to what we've been doing.
Let's touch base with Bianca again. Bianca.
Well, they've got to pull the trigger here, Rob Wright. He's putting Steph Wood on a goal attack. Susan Pettit is moving to goal shooter and Paige Hadley's coming on a wing attack.
Well, he's rolled the dice. He's waited for extra time. He is a tactician, a mastermind. But, gee, this is a massive gamble as we get underway for the final half of extra time. 7 minutes to play. And the moves have been made. Into goal attack, Stephanie Wood, the young gun, the Queenslander. Playing in the red. Her first attempt. The heart would be thumping. And she scores.
Wow, what an emotional time to come onto the court. Rob Wright has just done such a huge move. He has taken his foundation players, his most experienced players, off the court at the same time. Susan Pettit, Kim Green now out of the game.
Sarah was watching the Firebirds huddle in that little mini break. Sarah?
A much different huddle from the Swifts. They all stood individually across the transverse line. Little was spoken between any of them. Normally, Laura Geitz is really vocal at the huddles. She didn't have much to say to her troops. They know what they've got to do. They just have to get out there and do it.
Part of destruction centre. Part of destruction.
Well, Liza, she's starting to get all those little wins. She's been working her butt off for 60-plus minutes. The little wins are coming, but this is where the Swifts need to be composed. Just get the ball down the court and score from it. This is where the fresh legs will be handy.
Top of the circle. Wood's covered by McMiniman. Wood poking out. Waits eventually to level it up. To level it up in extra time. Well, it's a shame there has to be a loser today. What a display from netball. 9 years it's been the ANZ Championship. And what a way to bring the curtain down. Hadley in the pocket. Still a fair way to play in this ball game.
Well, that's right, Kel, with the double extra time, it's the first team up by two. If we get to that stage, this game could be going on for hours, the way it's going at the moment.
Composure from the young gun. She did it in Sydney in front of a record crowd back in round nine. Came on at halftime, won them the game. She was his wild card, the X factor, Steph Wood. And now on defence, harassing McMiniman to Revalian. This champion team tested like never before. Simpson. Hearts in mouths with every pass.
Okay, goal defense outside. Part of destruction.
Tippett straight for the jump pass. It's worked all season long and it works here. In the most intense white cauldron you could experience. If we are tied up at the end of this, we continue to play, must win by two.
You just got to wonder how Kim Green and Susan Pettit are feeling at the moment. They have absolutely no control on what's happening out on the court at the moment. As two of their senior players, this will be hurting them.
To put them back in front, and it wobbles in.
She is an impressive athlete, isn't she, Kel? She's just been thrown on at the most pressure cooker time and is delivering, Steph Wood.
Oh, the tension rising as the quality rises. Goal for goal. Neither
taking a backward step. 3 minutes to play. 64 goals apiece. One out in the circle is Thwaites and Geitz. Wood. Oh, it was ambitious. Geitz pounces. It's Geitz's moment. Laura Geitz has a say at the most important moment, and they can hit the lead with a goal here. Given away the contact though. Well, they had their chance to fire theirs and they'll get it again. She's feeling the pressure, Caitlin Thwaites. She is feeling the pressure. Again, this is brutal stuff. This is die for the ball type final. An absolute classic.
The Swifts can get a turnover here.
Tippett making sure that's not going to happen.
There's fans in here that can barely watch this. They are on the edge of their seat, grouping, pulsating. It feels like the words don't even do it justice. Twists and turns, unpredictable. Langman into Thwaites. She's stood up so far. She's playing the final of her life. She puts the visitors back in front with a minute to play. They've got the lead. Important passage of play the Firebirds have had all year, and they go the long bomb. It's worked all year. Does it work now? No. The yips are back. And she coolly delivers 60 goals apiece, but it is the Swifts with possession. The Swifts have possession. Swifts move it forward. Steph Wood from the bench to the hero. It's still alive. And we are going into double extra time. So we continue to play. There is no break. There is confusion all around. There is no break. The ball went out of play and the Firebirds with possession. Whoever wins by two wins the championship. Will it be the Firebirds back to back, or will the Swifts bookend it? 2008 and 2016.
Well, that last few seconds showed composure. Had the Swifts tried to bomb it in to get it there before time was up and it ticked over into the extra up by two, they could have lost possession.
There is no place to hide now. Tippett. The Swifts through Leighton.
Bring the fans contact.
So tired, they can barely get out of their own way out there at the moment, pushing themselves to the limit. Looping it over the top to Thwaites. To give them a one goal lead. And now the Firebirds. With an amazing, a huge mountain to climb here. It's just one goal. But if the Swifts get the next one, they win it. It's all on Aitken. They're tied up. put those championship celebrations on hold. This does not look like it's going to end any time soon. We are into double extra time. Simpson willed herself to the contest. Simpson to her best mate Revalian. Over the top to Aiken to give the Firebirds the lead.
And the centre pass to Falco. This could be the ball game. The pressure on the Swifts. They must turn it over.
Revalian, Tippett's gone down. She's able to get up quickly. Don't forget, this time last year, Tippett scored the winner. If the Firebirds score here, they're going to win it. Aiken to win the championship in double extra time. She's had the yips, she's had the wobbles. Can she win it for them? Brisbane Entertainment Centre explodes into a frenzy. There's tears of joy, there's hugs. They are ready to party. They will forever be known as the dominant force of this competition. And what a way to bring down the curtain in the ANZ Championship after 9 years. And to the New South Wales Swifts, your heart goes out to them. That is utter, utter devastation.